I'm Kim Coleman, a co-founder here at Paid Memberships Pro. In this section, I'm going to talk through the advanced settings in Paid Memberships Pro. There are a lot of advanced settings, so it's going to be a bit lengthy, but I hope I can give you a clear explanation of what these settings all do for our plugin. So navigate to Memberships Settings and click on Advanced. The first section here has to do with how our users that are just members of the site, they're not editing or creating content, how can they interact with the back end of your WordPress site? No one's going to be able to edit your settings or adjust your post content, but WordPress does allow people with the subscriber role to have a limited view of the dashboard. So you can check these boxes if you don't want people to be able to get into that limited view. I do recommend turning both of these settings on for most membership sites. Whether you restrict users with the subscriber role from accessing your dashboard, and then also disabling this black WordPress toolbar for users with the subscriber role. There are other screens in Paid Memberships Pro that allow users to edit their profile or change their password when they're logged in, so you don't need to allow the users to access these areas of WordPress. The next section has to do with how your content is displayed when protected content is in your site. Do you want to filter it so only members will see restricted posts and pages? Or do you want to allow or not allow members to see those restricted posts and pages? I'll show you an example of what this looks like. But let's look at this second section related to excerpts. So the excerpt is like the initial section of a protected post to show a teaser content about that content. So do you want to allow non-members to see excerpts of protected content? Or do you want to hide the excerpt from non-members? I like to set it up that non-members will see restricted posts and pages in searches and that you show excerpts. I think that's the best way to give non-members a teaser bit of content. But depending on how protective yours is, you might want to exclude these posts and pages from searches and hide the excerpts. So let's look at what that really means in practice. The site has a post called Hello World. It's the default post here in the site. If I edit the post and I set some membership requirements here for the premium membership and click save. Now, if I view the post, you'll see I do not see any excerpt of this content and it just shows that premium is required. If I adjust my event settings to show excerpts, I should now see a little bit of information from that post, that teaser content. If I'm on the homepage of my site too, you'll see this Hello World post in this theme shows up here. That's what the list of posts show up as. If I say only members will see restricted posts and I refresh, I'll no longer see that post as a person without the right level. So take a look at those settings, read some of our documentation related to them, and then you'll make the best call for your site if you want to show excerpts and if you want to show protected content in the normal browsing of your site. This next section is related to communications from us. So Paid Memberships Pro will send notifications when we recommend certain add-ons to be used in your site. Let's say you set up the BBPress plugin. You didn't know we had an integration that you can lock down forums by membership level. We'll show you a notification that you can do that. But you can turn off general notifications and show only security notifications. These are notifications when we detect that you're using an outdated version of Paid Memberships Pro that might have a vulnerability or other breaking functionality. And we just want to make sure everybody knows to upgrade to protect their site and to make sure that it functions as intended. So you can change your notifications to only show these priority security notifications. We also send from your site an email related to what's happening in the site. And it's not information generated from us or from our servers. It's all within your WordPress site. So do you want to receive a periodic email on a weekly, daily, monthly basis or never? Just recapping what's going on in the site. How many new members? How many members of each level do you have? Do you have any outdated add-ons? How many administrators are active in your site? Maybe leave it on. Get the first week's email, see if it's informative and helpful for you. If not, you can come back here, reduce the frequency to monthly, or turn it off and never receive that admin frequency email. The final section of advanced settings, and this can be expanded on if you have other add-ons, are just related to some other basic settings. Are you running ads in your site? If so, it gives you a script you can use to hide and show these ads by level. We have better tutorials on that if you need to read them. Requiring a terms of service at checkout. That's your choice. It would show up. I'll show you what this looks like at checkout. It shows up at the bottom and it requires people to agree. And then on the edit member screen, you'll see a digest of the agreements to your terms of service, just for legal reasons if you require that. Tracking is how Paid Memberships Pro itself receives non-sensitive information from your site related to activity, add-ons being used, number of levels, and what types of levels you have set up, just to help us build the best open source platform for you and just process that information. You can totally turn this off. It doesn't change what is available to you in your site. It's just if you want to send that information so that we can keep improving. Finally, this setting is only related to if you're leaving Paid Memberships Pro. Why would you do that? And want to delete the plugin and have it clean up all of its data. We added this because people were inadvertently deleting Paid Memberships Pro and their data was all being deleted. So by default, it's not going to clean itself up on plugin uninstall, plugin delete. But if you do really want to do that, have the plugin active, find this advanced setting, turn it back on, and then go through the process of deactivating and deleting, and there'll be nothing left in your database about Paid Memberships Pro. That's your choice. Yes or no? So these are my advanced settings. I'm going to save this just so we can see what the page at checkout looks like with the terms of service active. So I just clicked through from a protected piece of content. This is that checkout page we've been coming back to a lot today. And then here you see this new section, yes, I agree, to the sample page. They can click and open this to read your terms of service, or they can check this box. It will be required for members to check this box in order to proceed through the checkout process. That's the terms of service. That's the advanced settings. There's a lot to digest here. You're going to want to read the documentation about all of these settings so that you make the best choice for your site. Always come back later and change them at another time.